Hello, this is Mogli TV, and today we're going to talk about something that is a very common question amongst newbie VJs, which is how do I synchronize music to visuals? If we want to synchronize music to visuals, we first need to define what that actually means, because it's quite an abstract idea in reality. Although it seems like a very plausible and straightforward question, it actually isn't. So first, let's define what synchronizing music to visuals means. It can mean a variety of things, but the most straightforward meaning is to actually synchronize the beats per minute of the music playing, as in how fast the beat is going, with the action inside a clip. Now, not all clips necessarily adhere to having an action that relates to beats per minute. If there is no discernible action inside the video clip that can correlate with a BPM, what we usually mean by synchronizing is to make that clip loop in a number of predefined beats, usually 4, 8, 16, or multiples thereafter, although this is just a guideline, doesn't need to be that. But if we stick to the most common forms of dance music, you'll get that 4 on the floor beats. To demonstrate this, I'm going to use Triads 3, which is a VJ pack that I've got available on Gumroad, which is basically 3 clips that are designed to be used together on 3 layers. I've got the 2 top layers bypass at the moment, so I'm just going to show you this bottom bass clip here, which, as you can see, it's very simple. I'm going to change my BPM to 120 BPM. And as you can see here, the settings for the clip are BPM sync, and then I've got 8 beats, which is the length at which this clip was edited. So we can use a very handy tool in Resolume, which is this metronome here, which I'm going to switch on right now. And then I'm going to resync. And as you can see, the clip is in time with the metronome. So every 4th click of the metronome ends up with the clip having the animation on the bottom right corner. So now that we've got this synced, you can increase the BPM and you'll see that the clip stays in time with the metronome. So if I start increasing the BPM, you can see that that 4th beat of the metronome always ends up with the animation on the bottom right corner of the clip. So now that we've got that bass layer synchronized, let's bring in the other 2 layers. So first layer 2, and let's trigger it. Let's resync. And as you can see, that is in time with the metronome. If we look at the settings for that layer, again, it's on BPM sync. And this loop was edited to be 32 beats long, so that's what I've got here. Now, although it was edited at that speed, you could change that to make it go slower or faster. It's always a good idea to make your loops at 60 frames per second, so that if you slow them down, they've still got frames to play in a smoother way than if you had them like 30 or 24 frames per second. So if we divide by 2, you can see that it's still in time with the metronome, but it's going a lot faster. Alternatively, we could actually do the opposite and slow it down. At this stage, I'm going to have to add a disclaimer here that the video might not be exactly 100% accurate on the beat due to the fact that I've got Resolume running and I've got my podcasting software running on the same machine, and I'm grabbing the screen while I'm rendering visuals in real time. So there's a lot going on here and things might go off a bit. I'm going to bring in that 3rd layer that we've got here. So I'm just going to trigger it and just set it off from the bypass, and let's resync again. And this video, again, this top layer is 32 beats long and it's BPM sync again. And as we can see, hopefully, it's all running in sync. So now we're at this stage, there's a few useful tools and tricks that you can use. One of them is just using the resync button. Obviously, we've got the metronome playing here, which will reset the metronome at the same time, which is not what we want to be hearing. So I'm just going to switch that off. But if there was some background music playing right now, you could re-trigger the three clips at once as a way of re-triggering that whole action and keeping it at a specific spot, which is the beginning of all the animation. Let's say there's a build up with a drum roll going on, so you can just resync as quickly as you can and then just let go and the animation will carry on playing. So that's one thing that you can do. Another thing you can do once you've got your clips in sync to the BPM is use the cue points and the beat looper on the clip. So if we select our top clip here, I'm going to just switch these two off for now so we just focus on this one. So you can see this clip is basically a lighting effect that keeps moving, is 32 beats long. So what that allows us to do is to actually set cue points at different stages within the animation that you could trigger just by pressing one of these buttons. So I'm going to pause the BPM and now we can scrub on the timeline of our clip and find different points at which the clip looks quite different. So if you go through the cue points, it'll be quite evident that the clip changes. I've got some set already, but I'm going to set them up again so that you can see, for example, like if we set it there and click on this more button. Now, if we move that, we see that we jump to that position. So basically, if we scroll through and find points that, as I said, look different, now we can set that one. You could set that one and so on until you complete your six cues. So now if we unpause this, we can now, just by using the cue points, keep our clip on a specific point or area of its animation, which effectively works like having several clips. If you've got a MIDI controller with some pads on it, you could do some finger drumming on this through the beat or let it play. And at certain points, you can flash it or jump to another point on the clip. You can further use the cue points in combination with the beat looper. The beat looper does what its name describes. It'll loop your clip to a predefined number of beats that you can see here. So it's 4 beats, 2 beats, 1 beat, half a beat, etc. And basically, if we select, for example, 4 beats, and then we go to our cue point, it'll start looping 4 beats from the beginning of the cue point we've got. So again, as we were doing manually just now, we can now, without having to re-trigger the clip, have effectively 6 different 4-beat clips that are ready to go at the touch of a button. So we've got this one going. Now we've got that one. Now we've got that one. And again, you could change the beat looper setting to make it loop at a shorter time. So we can go for 2 beats. And again, jump around to different parts of our clip. Something to bear in mind, which is actually quite handy, is that our cue points that we set up to our clip are actually saved with the composition. And you can reposition them at any time by using the small button that is highlighted here. So you can change them if you wish, but it's also very handy to know that once you've set some cues up, they'll stay there when you save your composition. So you can always go back to them. If you've got a series of long clips, you know that you've got 6 subclips within that, especially if you use the beat looper in conjunction, as we've just demonstrated. Something to know when you've set your clips to be synced to BPM is the beat snap function. So if you go to your composition, you see you've got this beat snap here, which at the moment is set to none, but you could set it to 8 bars, 4 bars, etc. Basically, what this does is it quantizes, as in it makes sure that whenever you trigger the clip, whether it's on beat or off beat, it will appear at the right timing. So if you're not very good at doing things on time, it might be a good idea to set this up. I recommend that you've got it either set to none, because it's actually not that hard to trigger things in time. And sometimes you might want to trigger them off time, which is very handy as well. But if you want to use this feature, I recommend using the quarter bar, which is usually good enough to trigger things in time. Be aware that the beat snap is got a global setting for the composition, but you could override this from your clip settings here. So each clip could have its own setting specifically for itself. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this useful and that you apply some of the tips you see here to your VJ workflow. As always, remember to like and subscribe to support my channel, and hopefully see you next time. Bye.